Hi folks, it's Bruce at the Beach. This is our weekly television program on real estate, what's sold down here at the beach by all the realtors in town. Anything that's beach related is what I try and include. If it's the first time you've watched me, you can go to bruceatthebeach.net, click on recent sold properties, I think is what it is, and you can view all the different listing sheets with my handwritten notes that we're going over today. First thing I highlight is the listed price, then the sold price. 95% of the times they sell for less than what they're listed for. Then you have the association dues. If it's a condo project, you know, that can be hundreds of dollars a month. You need to know that. Next thing is the number of days on the market, DOM. From a negotiation standpoint, that's helpful. Then you have the sold price, what it sold for on a cost per square foot basis, and the same thing with in market price. Market price is what the comparable sales in the last 12 months have been in that building or in that neighborhood. Cameraman is looking at the clouds. We're hoping we don't get struck by lightning. It's been raining a good portion of the morning, so I'm going to try and zip through these. First one is Dolphin Key in Orange Beach, a nice low-density complex, only 28 units. It's on the beach, big units, about 1,700, 1,800 square foot, three bedroom, three bath, listed at 310,000, sold at 380,000, on the market 134 days. It sold at $224 a square foot, hadn't been a sale in there in a couple years, so that's the new comp. Nice complex if you like low density, not a lot of people. And a great rental complex as well. Seaside Beach and Racquet Club, much larger complex in Orange Beach, three bedroom, two bath, listed at $269,000, sold at $250,000, was on the market 263 days. It sold for $250 a square foot, market in that building, comparable unit, $239 a square foot. Upscale complex out on Fort Morgan Road, about 15, 18 miles outside of Gulf Shores. Upscale complex, number of buildings. This was the Beach Club and Catalina building, 705. Two bedroom, two bath. Listed at 299, sold at 280. On the market 57 days. It sold at $269 a square foot. Market in the buildings, 261. Pretty close to the money. West Wind, older building down in Gulf Shores. Now, some of the older buildings right on the beach down in Gulf Shores, if they're not wood structure, are a good buy. This is a two bedroom, two bath. Probably be a pretty reasonable rental unit. Listed at $219,000. Sold at $205,000. On the market for 67 days. It sold at $205 a square foot, market in that building, $223. That's a good value, especially if they're going to rent it. It's right in the midst of things down there. It'd be a good rental unit. Pelican Point in Orange Beach, three bedroom, two bath, listed at $338,900, sold at $330,000. On the market for 10 days, it sold at $254 a square foot. Market in the building is $273 a square foot. That's a good buy. Next one is Phoenix 7. This would be, from an investment standpoint, this would be a real rental machine as a building. One bedroom, one bath, listed at $219,900. Sold at $210,000, on the market 95 days. It sold at $263 a square foot. Market in that building, $263 a square foot. Right on the money. A little windy out here today. Next one is Tradewinds in Orange Beach, one bedroom, two bath, listed at $174,900, sold at $172,100, on the market 222 days, sold at $246 a square foot. The market in that building is $189 a square foot, so that's like $56 a square foot. That's way overpaying unless somebody's wife fell in love with it. That happens too. Now here's one that somebody fell in love with. Shoalwater in Orange Beach, three bedroom, two bath, listed at $350,000, sold at $350,000, full price, on the market one day. It sold for $292 a square foot, the market in the building, $233 a square foot. Somebody saw that unit the first day it was listed, absolutely fell in love with it, didn't care what the price was, they just wanted it, and they paid $60 a square foot, which would probably be somewhere in the neighborhood of probably $40,000, $50,000 too much. Anyway, to each his own. Next one is Caribe Resort, another upscale complex down here in Orange Beach in C Building. Three bedroom, three bath, nice place, cross street from the beach, listed at $389,000, sold at $385,000. It was a short sale. These units 4 or 5 years ago were selling for $500,000 to $700,000. On the market 97 days, it sold for $218 a square foot, and market is $239 a square foot. You know, not a bad buy. The next one is Windward Point here in Orange Beach. Nice place, all three bedrooms. Three bedroom, two bath, listed at $339,500, sold at $335,000. On the market 382 days. It sold at $279 a square foot. Market in the building, $258 a square foot. A little bit more money than I'd pay for it. Now, it did do $30,000 last year in gross revenue, so that they might offset it a little bit if you fell in love with the unit. Crystal Shores, one of my favorite complexes down in Gulf Shores, two bedroom, two bath. I think most everything in there is two bedroom, two bath. A great rental complex, newer building, I think built in 2004 or 5. Listed at $250,000, sold at $250,000. On the market 228 days, as I said, it was a short sale. It sold for $243 a square foot, market in the building $255 a square foot. That's a good reasonable buy, and would be a great rental unit. Those units in there rent like a house of fire. The last one is Sea Wind, a nice upscale complex in Gulf Shores, right down there near San Carlos in the lighthouse. It was another short sale. Listed at $289,000, sold at $286,000, two bedroom, two bath, on the market for 157 days. It sold at $253 a square foot. Market in the building is $267 a square foot. You know, it looks like we're gonna get this in without getting rained on. The sun has finally come out. If you have any questions, you know, I get hundreds of emails or registrations at the website every month, and you know, if you're looking at condos, and I see some of these folks that have looked at 1,000 pages on the website, give me a call, let me know how I can help you. If you want to pick my brain as far as what's a good complex, what's not a good complex, what's a great rental complex, what's it going to cost for a down payment, how much cash do I have to put in it, what are the interest rates, what are the insurance? What are the taxes? We'll do a cash flow analysis if you're looking at doing an investment, and we'll find out before you do anything whether something was going to cash flow or not. Just let me know. I'm here to help you. I will see you next week, Peanut. It's for those of you that watch every week, we don't have a water bowl out here today because it's really not that hot. It's breezy, and we had a little rain earlier in the first segment, but if I can help you, give me a call. My phone number is on the website, bruce@thebeach.net, or send me an email at bruce@thebeach@gmail.com. That's no spaces between the letters, bruce@thebeach@gmail.com. Give me a call. We will see you next week, and come on down to the beach.